And one part of this pro Lokpal and pro Anna Hazare and the pro cartoon campaigns by the left liberals, so called left liberals, has been to, you know, denigrate the at one level the political class, and the second level the whole area of democratic politics, because you know this is an old piece of wisdom developed by certain academic circle itself, that the political society in India has been closer to the people than civil society as such. So what we have here is an attempt to not just denigrate the political class or the area of politics, but also the area of you know, whole Dalit Bahujan articulation itself. So their way of negotiating with the democracy of with this nation, with this civil society, society by itself, is being sought to be denigrated. Even that they think needs to be mediated. The interaction between the political class and the Dalit Bahujan, which they feel essentially works against the good of the nation as they see it, the right thing as they see for the nation, and what is in their view just and equitable and egalitarian and democratic. This whole denigration of the political class is being repeatedly done. It is being systematically done. There is a whole class of NGOs and others who have sprung up talk about cleanliness in politics and efficiency and corruption in politics, and there are also a whole class of civil society groups which have sprung up, which question and raise doubts about all kinds of politicians and whole class of itself, right from parliamentarians to village level panchayats or to legislator in state assemblies. So these people, we'll have to look at the political class from the point of view of the Dalit Bahujans. From the point of view of the Dalit Bahujans, the modern the political class is the only class of people with authority who happen to view the Dalit Bahujan person, even if very infrequently or rarely and not for long periods of time, even if they are on a sustained basis, they view the Dalit Bahujan person as a normal kind of citizen. So whereas the other section among society, let's take the professional engineer, a doctor, a lawyer, are the elements in state machinery, like the government, like babus or the policemen, or the let's say doctors who are poor, are supposed to deliver public services to the Dalit Bahujan. None of them actually view the Dalit Bahujan person as an equal citizen. These are truisms in a way. So the dependence of the Dalit Bahujan on the political class is very great. it is this seems unacceptable to this left liberal civil society groups. We will have to question why they are unacceptable, why the civil society groups themselves don't seem to be generate as much loyalty or trust among the regular the Dalit Bahujans as among the regular other citizens or among the Savarnas. Why do all these holy cows like Anna Hazare or Aruna Roy don't generate the same kind of trust or inspire the same kind of interest among the Dalit Bahujans? So we need to question why these left liberals are what they are being trying to do, and what is this whole camp and what and how is it actually different from the Hindutva class of activists or bloggers or intellectuals who try to in a different way denigrate the same ideas of democracy and democratic politics and representative politics, and how they actually privilege certain ideas of nationalism over certain ideas of pluralism or of liberalism. So we need to question how different are the so-called left liberals from the right-wing Hindutvavadis. So